tomorrow, and Jake, you as well, one of the 30 participants. Best of luck to you.
I tell you, if I wasn't there to be a participant, I'd still be there to watch that championship match. We're going to see some stuff happen.
Thank you very much, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Aha.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we're live having a blast here tonight from Venom and Diamonds doing the cowboy Macarena, so yeah, to speak there, JR.
I don't think Doc quite got it right yet.
That's all right. Look, moving.
Doing his best there.
Oh, my goodness, it's all at the Alamo Dome, ladies and gentlemen. And speaking of which, last Monday on Raw, individual by the name of Psycho Sid, the World Wrestling Federation champion, had these comments. Let's take you back to Monday night.
See, over 100 years ago, a great German philosopher, he said, in the act of fighting monsters, in the procedure, be sure that you don't become a monster yourself. But in the Alamo Dome, I will have to be the monster to take what is mine, to walk out the World Wrestling Federation champion. And I think Shawn Michaels would say the same thing. But as the battle progresses, and at the right moment, I reach out, Shawn, and I have you by your throat. The look that you will give to me will be obvious. For over here, at ringside, will be your mother. And she will know that look too. And then all the way over here will be Jose. He will know that look too. But this time, he won't get on the apron because he knows better. And then someone told me that this section over here was going to be nothing but your friends from your hometown, Shawn Michaels. But they will see that look too. And Jose, you are going to summon all the Mexicans from Mexico and all above here they will be, 70,000 of them. And even at the highest seat in the roof, he will know that look too. And that look, it says it all. It says, Sid, you are the man. You are the master and the ruler of the world.
The WWF champion, ladies and gentlemen, Psycho Sid, defending the championship against the former title holder, San Antonio's own Shawn Michaels, tomorrow at the Alamo Dome. And yes, we're having a grand old time here. We're told that...
Listen, I know you Mexican boys.
Let's get our camera over there.
American way, but I'd like to teach you a little card game. I know you like to
gamble. He's a blackjack dealer tonight.
He might be right.
That's just a big gamble.
That's Histeria and Mini Mantine.
You win. Look, 125, I win. Thank you. Very good.
Hey, wait a minute. He just busted. If he's playing blackjack, he just busted.
I can see that right. You Mexican boys are really good players.
He just dealt from the bottom of the deck.
Watch now.
Well, he's cheating them.
Honky-tonk man. Look, I got another one. I'm winning again. Thank you very much.
Oh, come on. Look at Mini Mankind there.
You boys are really good players.
Taking exception.
I wish I had more time. I'd teach you how to speak English and play cards. It's too bad. Give me some fresh Mexicans in here that know how to play. Oh, you want one more? There you go, amigo. There's you another one. Look,
honky-tonk man, ladies and gentlemen.
No matter what.
He's cheating.
He's taking all our pesos.
Here. Give me some guys that can play some cards.
Mini Mankind and Histeria. On their way to the squared circle, we're going to have a Mini Mankind and Histeria.
That's what happens when you run across the border at nighttime.
Oh, my goodness. Against Mascarita Sagrada Jr. and Venum. A most unusual matchup, ladies and gentlemen. We've got two minis and I guess you'd call them two maxis.
Yeah, I guess so. This is going to be an interesting outing because it's our first opportunity here on Shotgun to see Venum and Mascarita. Well, we've seen Mascarita Jr., Mascarita Sagrada Jr., but we haven't seen a Venom and Histeria, nor have we seen Mini Mankind yet.
Coming up later on, Double J, ladies and gentlemen, Jesse James against the man from the Nation of Domination, Farouk, and of course, yet to see in action, well, in the squared circle in action, Goldust, who meets Stone Cold Steve Austin. What an extraordinary matchup tonight, ladies and gentlemen, right here on Shotgun Saturday night. And look at Mini Mankind. Maybe maybe he's seen too many late night movies. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. There's the Alamo Dome. We'll be right back with more Shotgun Saturday Night. Welcome back. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. We're
right back, New York. Ladies and gentlemen.
Bob Backlund is in New York City.
Morality.
We're in
back
San Antonio.
You got that?
Mr. Backlund. Hello. Hey, is anybody home? You're supposed to be here in San Antonio. Although next week, ladies and gentlemen, we will return back to New York City. Yes, we'll come to you live from the world famous Webster Hall. You want to talk about a party? Oh my goodness, Webster Hall will be something for the likes of which you have never seen before. Todd, where are you?
It's Mankind! Mini Mankind! I can't get his attention.
Why is he?
Let me try to get up there. Excuse me.
Does he have a short attention span? Or?
Excuse me. He's got a lot of things short. Mini Mankind, what's your strategy for this match?
Voy a ser número uno y lo voy a destruir y lo voy a acabar todo.
What would be the strategy involved?
Voy a acabar a Mascarita Sagrada y quiero su campeonato.
Something about a salad.
Quiero su campeonato de él.
Huh?
Quiero su campeonato de
él. The belt. You want the belt?
Noche, esta noche, mañana.
Mañana. That means tomorrow. Back to you.
I know what he said.
What?
What's that, JR?
Oh, he's talking about tomorrow in a preview channel, a free-for-all.
Oh, that's
that
right.
Mini's tag team matchup. Mascarita Sagrada Jr. considered, the greatest mini in the world today.
And here we go, Histeria and Venum going at it.
Very colorfully attired are these athletes.
I'll say.
Both of these are very young men in their early 20s. Both started as teenagers. And the man down now, of course, is Venum. Now back up.
Well, one minute over there by Venum. Nice escape.
Venum in the purple trim.
Purple trim. Wait, it sounds like a car or something. Purple trim with the white upholstery or whatever. Uh-oh, look out.
Don't forget, Steve Austin and Goldust still to come. And Double J and Peruke. That's going to be a good matchup.
Anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Certainly want to thank our great affiliate in San Antonio, KABB, the Fox affiliate. Did a phenomenal job in helping us promote the Royal Rumble.
Unbelievable!
Great counter to a head scissor by Venum.
Uh-oh, to the outside, Histeria. And Histeria, look at the way he gets back into the ring. Oh!
Tremendous move. Springboard from the top into a head scissors by Venum. Over the top.
Landed on his feet. Amazing agility. Look out. Nice drop. Roll right into the cacti. You know what happens there.
Yeah, you got the point.
Roll. Foot catapult.
Springboard plancha there by Venum.
Histeria and Venum going at it, and we haven't even seen the minis in the match yet. Oh, here we go.
Tag's made. If the tag is made on one team, the other mini has to come in.
Mini Mankind against Mascarita Sagrada Jr. Look at this. Mascarita Sagrada Jr. and White, and nice escape there. And an arm drag takedown.
Nice little arm drag. No pun intended.
To the outside. Mini Mankind. Watch out.
Watch this move. The little fellow take a chance. Crossbody right off the top.
And joining us now, ladies and gentlemen,
Steve Austin is here.
Stone Cold Steve Austin has elected to come out here and join us, and I don't know why. We are having problems with his microphone.
Oh yeah, that figures. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can.
Well, let's get something straight. Where do you go, huh? That guy, where's the other guy?
You
announcer, is he here?
No, he unfortunately has a throat problem.
Well, that's just as well, because he didn't have a throat problem. He'd have a throat problem by the time I got through with him. But as far as why I came out here, Vince, all the sense has been cutting me off. Now everybody at the USA Network's getting on Stone Cold Steve Austin because of all the 3 and 4 letter words I've been using. Let me clear something up right now. Why do I use those words, people ask me? Because I don't want to be misunderstood, misconstrued, or misinterpreted. Talking the way I do is pretty concise, and I think you can tell exactly what I'm saying. Is that true, son?
Oh, we hear you loud and clear, Mr. Austin.
Well, what's this in the ring here?
Oh,
these guys going to be in the Royal Rumble or what?
No, they're not in the Royal Rumble matchup. It's a watch out now. Venum trying to time this. Wait, what's he going to do?
Who knows?
Venom and Histeria going
at it. Oh, goodness gracious. You know, I wish those guys were in the ring, because that's the most colorful garbage I've ever seen in my life.
And what's going to happen tonight with you and Goldust?
Well, I'm just going to have to do what I do to everybody.
Oh,
I brought a six-pack of whoop-ass with me tonight, and I'm going to serve it to Goldust in front of the world.
Is it cold? It's
cold.
So
as far as tomorrow goes at the Royal Rumble, I got a case of whoop-ass I'm bringing, and every time I hear you talking about the Royal Rumble, you always say, there's going to be 30 superstars. Well, you're wrong, man. There ain't going to be 30 superstars. There's going to be 29 pieces of trash and one superstar, and that superstar is Stone Cold Steve Austin, and that's the bottom line, Vince. Tell me I'm wrong.
Unquestionably, you are one of the superstars, and maybe one of the great superstars.
There you go. At least show it. Give me a little credit while I'm out here, because I'm not going to take a browbeating out here, son.
You get credit. There's no question about that. However, it remains to be seen as to whether or not you are the winner of the Royal Rumble matchup.
Well,
as a threat, you're no different than the Bret Hart. A lot of individuals are going to be gunning for Bret Hitman Hart, and a lot of individuals are going to be gunning for you in the Royal Rumble as well.
There's going to be a lot of animosity going on in the ring here, because the bottom line is, I can't stand Bret Hart. I can't stand anybody in the ring.
Man, these
guys are going crazy.
And I must say, these minis are stealing your thunder, Stone Cold Steve Austin. They are really, look at this matchup. Anything
can happen.
Probably
stealing a little money in my pocketbook in the dressing room. They ain't stealing my thunder, son. And I'm begging you to get me a bigger chair, because I'm a big, strong guy, and I need a little room.
We'll make sure we take care of
that. Well, let's do that.
We didn't know you were going to join us.
Well, not like I said, you know, you ain't got to expect nothing up from me, but I'll tell you what you can from me. I'll fix you throw an elbow right in your teeth if you keep insulting me like that.
Sorry.
This ain't nobody's party but Stone Cold Steve Austin. This is Shotgun Saturday Night, man, and anything can happen. And I want to run my mouth. I want to speak my mind. And if you're going to yank me off on the air on the USA Network or Monday Night Raw or whatever, I'm going to get it in on Shotgun Saturday Night. And that's the bottom line.
I understand that. We loosen things up here a little bit. It's late night. It's the WWF Hit Shotgun. Look at that maneuver.
Oh, geez.
Nobody
Venum,
home.
Venum took a chance, and Histeria was able to move now. Let's see if he can capitalize. There's a power bomb. Shades of Psycho Sid.
He got him. You must be impressed, Mr. Austin, with the action you just saw.
Well, you know, I'm impressed. You know, it's like someone left these guys out in the sun too long and put them in a dryer. Bottom line is, these guys are great athletes, but if the bell rang and they look across the ring and they saw Stone Cold Steve Austin, well, there'd be a mess in the ring. Probably in the back seat of their pants, because there ain't no way one of these guys can last 1, 2, 3 minutes with Steve Austin, and that's the truth.
All right, go ahead and say it.
All right, I'm going to whip somebody's ass tonight.
Okay, that's what we're waiting for.
As you got it.
All right. Right now, we're told, ladies and gentlemen, that back at the Alamo Dome,
what?
We're going to take you back to the Alamo Dome, and wait a minute, that's George and Adam. Guys.
Hey, wait, what's that? Hey, what's TV?
Yeah.
Come on,
we got the camera on you guys.
What are those knuckleheads?
But it's a little early. Yeah, you're on TV, all right, George and Adam.
Alamo Dome, 1997.
They probably haven't showered in weeks.
Tomorrow night, baby, tomorrow night.
Yeah. All right.
George, camera's adding more than 10 pounds to you, buddy, if you know what I mean there.
Who is 10 pounds?
Oh, my
God. Uh-oh. It looks like George's going to have both seats all by himself.
Woo, psych.
All right.